So I went to Jamaica and I didn't tell Mr. Prince I was going. And Mr. Prince was like, where did you go?
I was so upset and worried.
I know.
I didn't know where she went. Every day I'm looking for her, I didn't see her. And I said, I think she's gone to Jamaica. And when she come back and said, you been to Jamaica? And she said, yes. I said, I thought so because I wasn't seeing her. I was hoping that you didn't get in an accident to the bicycle.
I love me and my
thank
bike.
God, thank God I see her.
For real.
She's here with me now.
Yes, I am. No, but for real, I thought I could call Mr. Prince from Jamaica, but then I forgot. Mr. Prince has the old school phone. I'm happy to be back.
That's Woo! Right. Welcome back.
Thank you.
I'm your dreams come true.
Beautiful people, we are now back in New York and I am back into the swing of things. It is fall and you can still absolutely forage in fall and winter. Right now I'm just re-upping on some things that I need. Here we have the chestnuts and I don't have gloves, so I won't be using my hands because my hands will literally, I don't even know. But oh my gosh, currently I am harvesting some raspberry leaves, ones that have not turned yet, so that I can utilize them for tea. Ooh. Ah, I'm so grateful. It feels good actually to, I don't know what I thought I was coming back to. I'm really excited to delve deeper into my foraging knowledge and journey, in that I will be hey in that I do want to be outside during the winter. I really want to like experiment with roots and box as well, so yeah, winter is right around the corner, isn't it, Journey? Yes it is. On the camera earlier. What is meant for you is meant for you. Oh my gosh. Wow, elderberries in New York for 2024. What is meant for you is meant for you. Wow.
Look at you. If we would have known.
For real.
Elder woods.
Wow. Wow, back from Jamaica. How does it feel? It feels quite good, you know. I feel like I got a good balance of like Jamaica, America, Jamaica, America, you know? I definitely spent way too much time outside today. Do I regret it at all? No. But I need to, I don't even know. I was gonna say I'm gonna do better, but really, I really believe that I'm supposed to be outside. That's what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm supposed to be with the plants every single day of my life. My friend got me this. It says, happy belated birthday, Imelda. So cute. And it's the cutest little cake in here. In a little cup. In a little chocolate cup. I actually got a lot of gifts this year. And I was actually kind of shocked. I said, wow, all these people giving me gifts. It's the first time I've gotten a personalized cup, birthday cupcake. What? Cupcake. Cupcake. Chocolate cupcake. What the hell? Why did I just make the correlation in this present moment? Cupcake. Cupcake. Chocolate cupcake. Wow. Wow. I want to show you guys some of the things I've got. So, a bowl of hawthorn berries. I wanted to show you guys what the tree looked like, but to harvest these, like, I couldn't even film it. I wanted you guys to see how crazy I went for the hawthorn berries. Oh, that's so good. Hawthorn berries, good for your heart. These are so flipping good. Hawthorn berries. Oh, another thing I harvested. I already ate basically all of them. So did I really harvest them? But these right here. Nanny berries, oh my gosh, this is one of my favorite things ever now. It's literally like a custard raisin. It's so delectable. These are the elderberries I got today. I'm actually gonna make something tomorrow. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna use this tomorrow. Oh my gosh. Take me back to Jamaica. It's cold. Whew. It's a new day. Let's rise. We're out.
You are my sun. You are my sunshine. You are my sunshine.
The sun is shining a bit. I'm gonna take off my jacket. I'm like, why am I seeing lavender in October? What?
Bruh.
What? Why am I seeing lavender in October?
I'm about to harvest it all.
What? I cannot believe I am harvesting lavender fresh from the garden. Are you kidding me? What? Yaro, don't mind if I do. Put a little bit in my basket. Look how colorful this is in October. Wow. I am honestly contented. This pomegranate has cracked, so I'm just gonna take it and inspect it. Whoa. Whoa. Focus. Woo. Should I taste it? Mmm. Oh. Oh, oh. Mmm. Oh, that's a good one.
Oh, yes.
Don't mind if I do. Harvested pomegranates this morning. Oh, the amount of joy. These are so flipping good.
You know that I'll always try to get it right. I'm working hard to leave my legacy behind. Yeah, you know.
There's still so much to harvest in late October. Like what? Bruv. Oh, abundance is our birthright indeed. Wow. Ooh. These peppers. Orders. I'm just gonna lay them out, get them done. We got work to do, baby. We got works to do. I just finished and we are about to run to the post office. I mean run. It's like 4:40. I don't even know, but yeah, I have a couple more, but I'm gonna do those tomorrow. Those are international packages and takes me a little bit longer. Someone from Iceland ordered. Woo. And someone from Canada.
Wow.
Yeah. People from Canada order a lot there. Iceland, I've probably gotten like one or two before from Iceland. And I'm always fascinated. I'm like, oh, Iceland? Welcome to my kitchen. Today, I was already making some elderberry juice with the elderberries that we got like 2 days ago. Because there's no point in storing them. If you've been watching my videos, you saw I harvested a lot of elderberries this season and some really, really juicy, juicy, beautiful, succulent elderberries. So with what I harvested the other day, I was like, I need to use them immediately. So I'm just gonna make a juice that I'm gonna drink throughout the rest of the week. I put sumac in here, elderberries, ginger, lemon, cayenne. Ooh, I like that. That's some good juice. Okay, so now I'm gonna make some pepper soup with everything that I harvested from the garden. African pepper soup, I am excited. The only things that I'm gonna use that I did not harvest from the garden, some plantain and the sweet potato. I'm so excited. This is more like vegetable pepper soup, but it's really good. Like, woof. You ever make anything and you're just like, oh yeah, so good. Good soup. Is this what they call a mocktail? Ooh, medicinal mocktail. Mm-mm-mm. It's so good. Wow. Perfect. Mm. I'm telling you, the cayenne pepper and elderberry juice is a game changer. It's not just a ginger, it's... attempt to make some jam, quince jam, or some juice, or a syrup. I don't know which one yet, I haven't decided. So for my 90 day leadership program, one of our assignments was to create a legacy project, and we decided to focus on environment as well as mental health. So we are raising money for two different nonprofits, and one of the other things that we did was this park cleanup that I helped organize, and it's been so lovely. Been cleaning the park all morning. Got here at like 8:50 and we were set to clean it from 9 to 12. So we're almost there. But yeah, so many people came out. It's such a nice, beautiful fall day. Right by the river. We found ample bikes. Ugh, ample e-bikes. Not only are we cleaning the park, we're also raising money for two different organizations. For New York Restoration Projects, helping to preserve green spaces in New York City, and the Jed Foundation, which helps to prevent teen suicide. So yeah, we are making a difference in the way in which we can.
Right, at least 40 bags, honestly, and like 100 bikes at this point. A rocking chair, like, this is ridiculous. And all of these things do end up in the river after a while, you know? They may end up on land first, but they end up in the river, and that affects us as well. So this really does make a massive difference. So I just want everyone to say thank you to themselves, honestly, for being here. For real, thank you.
After the park cleanup, we had one more event, which was a ticketed event where all of the proceeds would be going to our chosen nonprofits. With that, we had ample performers, a lot of DJs. We also had many prizes that could be won if you entered a raffle. And we also had speakers. I spoke on behalf of the environment, and one of my teammates spoke on behalf of mental health. And at the end of it all, I believe we raised 13K as a team. We also went ahead and started our own nonprofit during these 90 days. So much, so much happened within these 90 days, and I'm grateful for them. These last 90 days have been some of the busiest for me, and also a massive stretch in testing my ability to work cohesively with a team of people, primarily with just strangers in general from all different backgrounds, all different ages. And obviously now they're not strangers, but to think that at one point I didn't know these people, and I've spent the last 90 plus days with some of them is wild. I have not enjoyed every minute of it, definitely not, but I am absolutely grateful for every minute of it and the ways in which it has really allowed me to take myself on. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Have a beautiful day.